What is up, all you try-hard gamers? I launched Patreon. Woo! Okay, so this is, I know I already streamed once tonight, but I thought I'd do a special late-night launch or video for a live stream, rather, so I can't talk for some reason, for the fact that I launched my Patreon. So if you guys want to support the channel, it would be much appreciated. The link should be down in the description. So, what are we doing tonight? Well, for those of you who didn't stop by earlier tonight, I had a lot of success with my federal gunship build, my whole tank federal gunship build, and we are going to trick that puppy out even more than what it was tricked out. So, that's what we're doing tonight. So my goal is to outfit it with all plasma accelerators. I'm not exactly sure how well that's going to work out, given that I'm going to have to refit the overcharged power plant on it, and that's going to take away from the heat reduction. So I'm probably going to have to definitely move to Desiat to put clean drive tuning on the drives, as well as thermal spread. I'm thinking that's going to be an absolute must, because what I don't want to do is cook myself, right? I don't want to cook the ship. So it'll be interesting. I'll put those on there, the plasma accelerators, try it out, and if it doesn't work, then I'll just keep the current build that I have on it. Right now, we're moving to Moraire so that I can pick up the federal gunship. And then we're gonna have some fun. Hey, what's going on, Sean? Good to see you again, buddy. Did you have a good nap?
Frameshift drive charging. Two.
Flight Operations Bureau offers their warmest greetings, Commander. Access permitted. Please land on designated pad number 10. Use of automated docking computer permitted. You are clear to hand over control.
That's awesome, man. Glad to have you again. Yeah, I wasn't going to do another one tonight, but in virtue of the fact that, like, I got that Patreon set up and the last stream went so well, I was like, what the hell, why not? The game's much more fun when I have you guys here with me anyway. Well, here's the thing. I love seeker missiles. I absolutely love seeker missiles. But for long-term engagements, for the damage that they do, they just don't hone in on enough damage, as far as my opinion is concerned, to justify them being used for like a main damage weapon. Let's swap out this power plant here. All right, that should be enough power for what we need. You know, I wonder if I have more 6A thrusters with clean drive tuning somewhere. No, I sure don't. Well, it looks like I'm going to have to make a trip up to Desiat. Optionals are looking good. I might want to make that a 6A AFM. I might want to put reflective plating on these, though. Alright, off to Desiat we go.
exit the station safely and promptly.
Landing gear retracted.
Sean, what's your main ship that you fly?
Thank you.
Gunship drive charging.
My thoughts on Odyssey, I don't know yet. I think the concept of being on foot really appeals to me, but I hope to God it doesn't take away from, like, the main theme of the game, right? Because, I mean, Elite Dangerous is... It's mostly all about the ships right now, right? Now, I'm not sure if allowing players to get out on foot and do the first person thing will sort of confuse the play style. I'm not sure about that yet. I mean, it looks good for what it is. I'll have to play it to see.
Frameshift drive charging.
I mean, one thing I really liked about what I saw in the alpha was the ability to, like, it's the little things that Elite Dangerous always gets right? Like, being able to cut the welds of a panel in order to get to your objective. Like, it's little stuff like that that I enjoy. So I think that looks good for sure. For me, I'm not really interested in the first-person combat. Like, I came to Elite Dangerous to fight with starships and stuff, right? So, that's what I'm interested in. What I'm more interested in, though, is seeing what new ships they're going to add into the game. I think that's going to be interesting. I'm hoping there's a lot of them. I mean, I switch ships like nobody's business, like toilet paper. Because I'm constantly... I mean, the main theme of this channel is Elite Dangerous builds, and I've got to be, like, adaptable when it comes to that sort of thing. So I'm hoping to come up with something new and fresh for ship concepts.
orbital flight engaged.
Yeah, I've got some favorite ships for sure. Well, it's kind of hard to say. I really, really like and wish that a lot of the small ships were more viable in some of the in-game content, even with engineering. I mean, technically, so for example, as far as viability, my favorite small ship is the Vulture. But it's not because of the two large hardpoints. It's because of its ability to pitch extremely quickly, right? I really enjoy the Eagle. And I know technically in the hands of like a really, really skilled player, you can have an Eagle kill like an Anaconda or a Federal Corvette or whatever. But it's not efficient, right? So what I'd like to see is like using, I'd like to see them make the small ships more efficient for being able to do in-game content. Medium ships, I'd have to probably say my favorite is the Mamba. I really like the Mamba. Large ships, it's going to be a toss-up between the Clipper. I really enjoy the Clipper. And the Anaconda.
Oscar Delta, commencing automated flight control routine. Please observe docking protocols. Access granted. Proceed to landing pad 07.
Whoa! Slow down there, buddy. Slow up. Oh no! You guys didn't see that. I'm supposed to be a professional. How could I do that? Alright, that's done. Alright, what's next on the list? Probably head to Jameson Memorial. Okay, store the pulse lasers, buy, outfit everything else with plasma accelerators, and then head off to Alioth. How do you say that? Alioth to engineer them.
Landing gear retracted.
flight control routine. Safe travels, Commander.
Frameshift drive charging.
I personally... Marsupial, I personally use the Anaconda for combat. I know it's really, really good for mining, and you can use it for exploring and stuff like that, but mostly, like, I'm not really interested in any of that. I only do mining when I need, like, an influx of cash, like if I'm running low or something like that. And exploring, I only do every once in a blue moon. So every ship that I use for combat. The Anaconda is really good, in my opinion, for combat. Here's the thing, though. The Federal Corvette pretty much outdoes the Anaconda in every aspect when it comes to combat. It's more maneuverable. It's got two huge hard points on it. The only thing that the Anaconda is better, in my opinion, than the Corvette at is hard point placement. So, it's a toss-up, right? So, you might be asking, why don't I like the Corvette over the Anaconda? And that probably comes down to pure aesthetics. It comes down to, like, the way that the ships look. You know, am I willing to trade off the extra huge hard point for aesthetics? Yeah. You know, it sounds stupid, but I'm just that kind of guy. I love the Imperial Courier. Yes, I do love the Imperial Courier also. That's a really, really good ship. If there was any ship outside of the Vulture that was capable of, like, being able to do in-game content or come close to it, the Courier would probably be one of those ships. It's got three medium hard points on it. The hard points are pretty well close together, and my God, is it fast. It is quick as hell. And not only that, it's got the view from the cockpit is amazing. Looks like you're fighting in the cockpit of an F-16. It's cool as hell. I was saying, I think earlier today, one thing that I wish they would make viable for PvE are mines. I would absolutely love to see them make mines viable for PvE. I love that concept. I spent a good maybe 3 weeks on a bunch of small ships outfitting them with reverb cascading mines, and I was trying to make it viable, like, because the concept of destroying another ship's shield generator, not taking down the shields, destroying their freaking shield generator, I thought that was awesome. But they've got the AI to a point where they'll just almost always avoid it. I managed to take down one ship's shield generator with an Eagle. And I thought I was getting somewhere with it, and I just threw up my hands and said it's not worth it. 4, 3, 2, 1. Yeah, the Type 10's fun if you can get past the hard point placement and how much of a brick it is to fly. That's a big downside of it, but my God, does it have some firepower on it.
Fuel scooping.
I'll tell you what, you ever want to have a blast in a Type 10? You outload every one of those hard points with cannons and force shell. Doesn't matter what else you put on there, whether you put long range on them or overcharged. Holy shit, is that a blast.
Frameshift.
With the amount of hard points that the Type 10 has on it, when a ship, you know, the ships that you're fighting typically, like, make a U-turn and then fly straight at you, if you fire a full volley of four shell cannons at them, at most ships, it will knock them back, even though they're heading towards you. Large ships like the Anaconda, you can actually hit it at an angle and keep the ship to a point where it will not allow it to face its hard points towards you. It's really, really fun. Yeah, cannons, man, I got a love-hate relationship with cannons. I mean, it's a trade-off because if you don't put overcharged on them, they don't do enough damage, in my opinion, to make them that viable. But if you put them on overcharged rather than high capacity, then you're going to have to synthesize ammo. And the cannon ammo synthesis is expensive as shit. Loop of shame. Or not. Idling at 29 degrees, which is not amazing. I'm pretty sure putting all of those plasma accelerators on here is probably going to fry me, but we'll give it a shot and see what happens. get this puppy outfitted. Yeah, marsupial, that's part of the reason why I don't like them. I mean, if you stay within effective range of them, they can be okay if they're overcharged, but if you don't have them overcharged, they're not that good. Oh, look at that. I got two mediums right here already. Yeah, I was wondering if I could, let's see, what if... Scrap. Let's hit the alley off. Because we sure as shit do not need thermal conduit. I think that's everything. I really like the FDL. I actually, as much as I like the Mamba, I'm in a sort of torn between the FDL and the Mamba, specifically because the FDL is so maneuverable. I'm a big fan of maneuverable ships. I think that it's going to depend on what you want to use the cannon. And it's going to depend on what your other weapons are. Cannons, in my opinion, really are not worth it unless they're grouped with a shitload of other cannons, you know? So it seems like you could use that slot for something better. If you're just using it alone, I don't really see much use to it, but...
Charging.
Frameshift drive charging.
Thinking about it now, I suppose I can engineer these plasma accelerators for efficiency. I'm wondering if that would be the best way to go about doing this, since I'm doing an all plasma accelerator build. Problem with power play. I mean, I'm not a power play player in the sense that, like, I play it constantly. I just do it to get the power play weapons. But I don't, I'll tell you what, I don't see a reason to make a player wait 4 weeks to be pledged in order to get the power play weapons when the weapons are not really all that good. I mean, for PvP situations, the pack hounds are really good, right? For taking out modules and stuff like that, but they're not, like, OP enough to make somebody wait 4 weeks. Thank you.
Gunship drive charging.
You guys ever wonder why the Clipper is categorized as a large ship outside of its size? When you look at it, it's got like all the hard points and the utility slots of a medium ship. It's got four utility slots, four hard points. I have no clue why they made that a large ship.
Orbital flight engaged.
Winston, right now I'm experimenting with a mostly plasma accelerator build. And then two seeker missiles in the small slots for taking out hard points. I'm gonna check it out. I mean, I've done all plasma accelerator builds before, and I mean it's not turned out that well. So we'll see if it works. We'll see if it works or not.
flight control protocol initiated. Please submit a request prior to landing. Docking permission authorized. You may proceed to landing pad 07.
Let's try not to have a repeat of what I did before. Focused weapon. I just might go with focused weapon. Doesn't do much for heat. Shit, the only thing I can put on this thing is thermal conduit. Oh, let's see here. I just know I'm gonna cook the shit out of this thing. It's gonna happen. All right. Well, when I get out of firing range, I'm going to see whether a volley of these plasma accelerators is going to overcook my ship. I am almost positive it's going to. Here's the moment of truth. Okay, so let's see. It's not as bad as I thought it was going to be. If I can somehow squeeze that low emissions power plant on and then manage the overdraw in power in the module groups, I can get the heat down to where it probably will not overcook my ship with a volley. I mean, in theory, if I wanted to keep the power plant that I have on it, I probably could and just add some heat sinks. Because it's not completely overfrying the system. It's just taking me up towards like 100 degrees, something like that. 100% heat, so I could swap out the chaff for the heat sinks. That's always an option. And I mean, heat sink ammo is really easy to synthesize.
charging.
I like that name. The only thing I'll change is remove the and put an in. So bacon eggs. Ship is forever dubbed bacon eggs. So when I do an official build video for this thing, that's what I'll do is I'll name it bacon eggs.
Frameshift drive charging.
Someone reminded me to get limpets when we hit Morare before the battle test of Scotty.
Fuelscoop disengaged. Frameshift drive charging.
Nah, I don't have a Discord server. I frequent one, but it's more of a philosophy debate server.
Four, three, two,
but, I mean, if I get enough people that are active on the channel, I mean, I might think about opening up one. You know, that would be fun.
Thank you. disengaged. Frameshift drive charging. Frameshift drive charging. Fuel scoop disengaged. Frameshift drive charging.
Five more jumps.
Thank you.
almost there, folks.
Fuel scoop disengaged. Frameshift drive charging.
Alright, let's get down to business here.
Flight ready. The Imperial Flight Operations Bureau wishes you a pleasant and productive visit, Commander.
Okay, I'm going to put that power plant on and see where we're at as far as power and what we can cut to save. Megawatts is not that bad. It's not that bad. he would have gotten way at the library. Delivery, whatever you call it. Ew. That's not bad.
Cargo hold at maximum capacity.
Firing groups, let's see. Kill warrant scanner. I'm actually gonna do this. Then missile rack. Then repair Olympic controller. Alright, let's look at the modules. 10% power. Well, shit, this'll do it right here. I'm good to go. That's 11% power right there. That'll take me down to 99. So that's good. What was the other thing I was going to do? Ah! And of course there are no heat sinks here. No, I'm not playing in open. Usually when I'm testing out a build, I don't play in open. I mean, especially since I have to go back and forth from Jameson Memorial. I don't want to be, like, blown out of the sky in mid-build, so... Alright, round two of testing this build.
Objective detected.
the moment of truth. Look at that, we're running at 19% heat idle. That's at least 10% heat off what we were running before, so that's really good.
Scan detected.
Fucking thrusters out. Let's just forget that that happened. Okay, not bad, not bad, except for the fact, did you guys catch what happened there? Did you guys catch that? Okay, so About a good, I don't know, quarter of that battle, what happened, and I'm ashamed to say this. I used flight assist off to get my bearings on the bogey, and forgot that I had it off, and I was like, why the fuck am I bouncing all over the place? Are my thrusters out? What is this? Bobbing up and down like Muhammad Ali there for a good 30 seconds to a minute mid-fight. I use mouse and keyboard. I don't have a stick yet.
Module repaired.
Yeah, you're right there. This point defense turrets were like Let's try this again and do it a little more clean. Goodbye.
Target destroyed.
This will be a real test. Yeah, so far I think I'm liking it. I like the DPS for sure. I miss the short range blaster DPS though. Not gonna lie. I mean, for this build though, it's decently good. I mean, we're not taking an insane amount of damage either. So. Thank you. 3. I take these guys on. Now, I see an anaconda down there somewhere. I saw it before. If he doesn't jump out before we repair, I might give him a shot. There she is. Get this whole health up a little bit. We'll take on that anaconda. I hope I have enough ammo for him.
Scan detected.
He's overcooking himself so much that he's not able to fire his weapons.
Thank you.
10 shots left. Boom! I've never seen them do that before. Did you guys notice he like wasn't firing on me at all? I wonder if when I was doing that DPS to him in the beginning of the fight, he cooked his ship so much that he damaged his weapons through those shield cell banks. I wonder if that's what was going on. Repair to full, then go get reloaded, and then we'll see if we can pick up some missions. By the way, for you, those of you who haven't been here since the beginning of the stream, I just launched my Patreon. If you want to support the channel, I mean feel free to join. There are three tiers. If you go to the website, it's in the description. It'll tell you what those three tiers are and the things that you get for the different subscriptions or whatever. So if you'd like to do that, it would be appreciated. If not, that's cool too. Do I have enough ammo to take this clipper out? I'm gonna try it, what the hell. And if I run out of ammo, I'll just hightail it out of here. I ate that fucking clipper for breakfast. I should probably turn in these bounties too when I go to repair. Yeah, I got 12 million. From my squadron, just right there. I think I could turn them in here at this in the system.
Target
The real test will be the missions, because it seems that the mission ships are a step up above as far as durability than the hazardous resource extraction site ships. said that clipper got clapped. Clapping them cheeks. Jesus Christ. You guys are gonna fucking kill me, I swear to God. I hate these stations. It's always hard to find the pad on these stations.
Docking request granted.
Damn right, docking request granted. See, this is what I love the gunship for. The federal ships, like the dropship, gunship, and assault ship, a lot of people don't like their drift. I love their drift. I don't know what it is. There's something about sort of being able to calculate where you're going to be at, where you're going to land at when you're in the middle of a dogfight that's really, really awesome.
Landing gear deployed. Engines disengaged.
Oh, that's a cool 13 million.
Incoming message.
All right, see you later, Sean. That's what I get for not paying attention.
this facility is undesirable and measures will be taken to restore peaceful operations.
You know what we should do? Let me go to a raw material trader. Because I don't think I have that much manganese.
This facility's airlock is designated as a through zone only and will be kept free from stationary obstructions.
Yeah, I only have 9. Let me research a material trader real quick.
Pilots are gently reminded that the docking bay operates under a time slot traffic system and thanks them.
All right, we have a system.
Attachment sequence complete. Please exit the station safely and promptly.
deployed.
Kind of low on raw materials. I think it only costs one manganese though, if I remember correctly. Yeah, it's only one. Alright guys, I think that's gonna about do it. Thank you guys so much for watching twice in one night. That's awesome. And remember, the Patreon's up. If you want to pledge or whatever, I'd really appreciate it. It would help the channel out, help me out. You guys have an amazing night. Catch you later.